If you don't change these 5 settings in Adobe Premiere Pro right now, your exporting speed is going to be slow. The playback is going to lag. The chances of Premiere Pro crashing will increase and even your audio might start lagging. So stick until the end of this video and make sure you change all these essential settings. Go to Edit, Preferences, and then choose Memory. Here, you can see the RAM installed into your computer, the amount of RAM reserved for other applications and the amount of RAM available for Premiere Pro. Keep the RAM reserved for other applications as minimum as possible, so that a large portion of the RAM is available for Premiere Pro to use. By doing this, you can improve playback lagging and increase the exporting speed. The amount of RAM could be changed by clicking on this number. Next, go to the Media section. There is an option called Enable Accelerated Intel H.264 Decoding. Make sure to check this box. This option can vary according to the version of the software you have in your computer. As an example, some of you might have these two options. Just look out for the terms Accelerated and Decoding and check those options if they're unchecked. Doing this will speed up your exports. The next important setting you should change is the Automatically Refresh Growing Files setting. What this setting does is check for constantly changing media every 60 seconds. This setting has caused performance issues for a lot of users, including slowing down the computer and constant crashing of the software. So unless you have media that's constantly changing, make sure to uncheck this option. It's going to save you a lot of trouble. After that, go to the Media Cache section. The location for media cache files should be the fastest drive in your computer, such as an SSD. You can also put the location of an external hard drive if you don't have an SSD. This is not necessary, but doing this will improve the performance of Premiere Pro, so absolutely do this if you can. Also, if you haven't done it before, make sure to delete your unused media cache files. By doing this, you can free up space from your computer. Afterwards, make sure to check the option that says, Automatically delete cache files older than 90 days. You can even change the number of days if you want to. By doing this, you won't have to manually delete your unused cache files. But if you encounter any performance issues, it's still a good idea to come here once in a while and manually delete your unused cache files. After that, go to the Audio Hardware section. Here, I'm going to change the latency to 50. Having a high value for the latency might cause your audio to lag, especially in large projects, so make sure to change this setting as well. Yes, I have a bonus tip for you as a thank you for watching this video until the end. Go to File, Project Settings, and then General. In the Video Rendering and Playback section, choose the GPU acceleration option. Some of you might have different options for GPU acceleration depending on the version of the software in your computer. So in this case, you can either do a little research on which option you should choose or just keep the default option. Either way, the GPU acceleration option is going to speed up your exports. But if you have an old computer, I suggest you choose the software-only option because some users experience glitches in the playback and the exported videos as their computer can't handle the GPU acceleration option. Let me know in the comments below whether changing these 6 settings made a difference for you. If you found value in this video, make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Turn on your notifications so that you won't miss any videos like this. You might find these videos helpful as well, so go ahead and check them out. I'll see you in the next video.